my god. Did you guys see that Amanda Bynes went crazy?
Good.
Again?
Was she the one that like played in Mean Girls?
Well, she went crazy too.
No, she's the one from She's a Man.
Guys know that She's a Man is actually based on Twelfth Night by Shakespeare. Actually, I have it right here. We're reading it for one of my classes.
Oh yeah, I read that in high school. It's probably why She's the Man's based on it. It's a total chick flick, man.
somebody totally missed the point of Twelfth Night. It was totally about feminism.
Gay rights.
Feminism.
Look, just because they wore tights back then doesn't mean they were gay. I mean, that was just style back then.
See, it is about feminism.
I never said I agree with you.
Okay, hang on. Calm down. Why don't we talk about it?
Okay, let me see that. How do you explain this? Act 1, scene 5, lines 259 through 265. Your Lord does know my mind. I cannot love him. Oh, I mean...
That's supposed to be y'all.
Know him, noble. Of great estate, of fresh and stainless youth, in voices well divulged, free, learned and valiant, and in dimension and by the shape of nature, gracious person. But yet I cannot love him.
Obviously, she's taking a stance for what she really wants. She doesn't want Orsino just because people think that he's like, oh, he's so great, all these positive attributes. She's going after Cesario because that's what she really wants and that's what women should do.
Well, that's a good point, but at that
you're
point...
a little cool. Back to my point, though. See, Olivia's totally ungrateful. Like, Orsino has it all and stuff, but then Olivia still doesn't want him. What does that say about...
But that's not what we're talking about. You're just bitter because you get friend-zoned by every girl that you meet. What I was gonna say is that Olivia hadn't even declared her love for Cesario at that point.
Oh. Well, I have a theory that the reason Olivia doesn't like Orsino is because she's into girls. Here, give me the book. For example, in Act 1, Scene 5, says, thy tongue, thy face, thy limbs, actions and spirit, do give thee fivefold blazon, not too fast, soft, soft, unless the master were the man. How now, even so quickly may one catch the plague? See?
It's really easy to dress up as a convincing man, you know. I swear, I am not that I play.
Yeah, but even that line that says, even so quickly may one catch the plague, shows that Olivia doesn't even like the idea of love because she's independent and doesn't need a man. I mean, she calls love a plague.
No, I still think she's into chicks.
Excuse me! Women, not chicks.
Anyway, back then it would have been hard for anybody to admit they were gay. Since Olivia had a higher estate, she would have run the risk of losing her status.
Well, even today, people struggle with coming out of the closet because it's still looked down upon in society. Like, I bet if a politician were to come out of the closet, the moral majority folks would come out and start some kind of campaign to get him out of office.
Well, I saw on Fox News that they proved that the gay agenda was totally legit.
Anyway, I can see Olivia being in the closet.
Or she doesn't want to conform to how society says a woman should act.
Or that.
But at the end of the play, the only person who truly gets what she wants is Viola. Only because her desire is considered acceptable in society. Think about it. Antonio wanted Sebastian, what might be perceived as homosexual desire. It didn't get him. He ended up alone even though he was open about his love for Sebastian. From the very start. Now Orsino unconsciously wanted Cesario, another homosexual desire, and didn't get Cesario, who he loved, but rather got the socially acceptable alternative, which was the female version, Viola. And Olivia too wanted Cesario. Now that she liked him for his womanly attributes, but since she was actually a woman, she opted for option number two, which was Sebastian. Marriage therefore sort of used as a way to fix gay people and getting them to live by the rules of society.
No. But marriage isn't some evil institution that serves to enforce patriarchal structures or anything. It's about people making a promise to each other. To be together for the rest of their lives. Our ideas about traditional marriage aren't even traditional. And the word traditional, like, what does that even mean? When people use religion to justify infringing someone's right to make that promise to each other just because they're the same gender, like what we're seeing today, that's just a total perversion of religion. Marriage wasn't even born from religion. It was adopted by it.
I still think Amanda Bynes is hot.
But what about Channing Tatum?
Oh my god, he was so hot.